day of pride for the state of Oklahoma as the road to the Final Four moves into the second round in a sold-out Myriad in Oklahoma City. A very partisan crowd split, perhaps somewhat evenly, as the Tulsa Golden Hurricane and the Oklahoma State Cowboys meet. Tulsa, the one of only two 12 seeds to win in first round action, trying to survive and get to Dallas. Hi, everybody. I'm Ted Robinson. Oklahoma State today, though, starts with one hurdle to clear. Senior forward Fred Burley, suspended by Coach Eddie Sutton, a violation of team rules involving curfews. Burley will not play today, so Oklahoma State loses a veteran key member up front. But Greg Kelser, I think one of the keys for Oklahoma State today, perhaps their biggest key, has to be getting Bryant Reeves involved.
Well, Bryant Reeves had a very subpar game against New Mexico State, and Oklahoma State won anyway. I don't think that can happen twice, but there has to be a better collaboration between Reeves and his perimeter teammates. If he's going to get the ball today, he's got to remain active, can't get frustrated, and as a seven-footer, be a big target inside. His teammates on the perimeter, be more patient with him, allow him to work himself free. They had 22 turnovers the other night, many of them trying to get the ball inside the Reeves when he was not open.
Much of the nation learned about Tulsa for the first time Friday here, their remarkable game against UCLA, and they learned a lot about Gary Collier.
Well, Gary Collier, the Missouri Valley Conference's player of the year, he's superb. He's elevated his game, 34 points against UCLA, 35 the game before that. But the emphasis today, I think, will be on their point guard, Alvin Williamson. Here's a guy that handles the ball, played 40 minutes against UCLA, no turnovers, only 35 turnovers all year, which is sensational when you consider that Tulsa's an up-tempo team.
Looking at the starting lineups, Tulsa with no surprises, and up front, of course, they bookend the senior Gary Collier with outstanding freshman Shea Seals, and J.R. Rollo will have a huge chore today in trying to slow down Bryant Reeves. But the key in the lineups for Oklahoma State, Greg, they replace Burley, a forward, with a third guard, senior Brendan Manzer.
Well, they know that they're going to get a little pressure and they may need better ball handling, so they bring Manzer in to try and take away some of the ball handling responsibilities from Brooke Thompson.
And Eddie Sutton, of course, today is going to rely a lot on his team's defense. It's something Oklahoma State takes great pride in under Eddie Sutton, and hoping that that defense will not allow Tulsa the kind of shots they got against UCLA. And for Tubby Smith, he knows his kids know they're for real. They weren't surprised that they were able to beat UCLA. Now it's a game against a team they're very familiar with.
Exactly. You know, word was prior to this tournament that UCLA, their players, they didn't know where Tulsa was. Well, after Friday, Tulsa said, hey, look into the second bracket, the second round. You'll find us.
Don Rutledge is our lead official. Duke Edsel and George Watts also working. Oklahoma State in the white with big country. Bryant Reeves had just 5 shots against New Mexico State on Friday, the lowest he's had in the game this season. Collier working against freshman Keontae Roberts. And right away, J.R. Rollo gets an offensive rebound and a reach-in foul on the Cowboys.
Right away, they go into the post. Does Tulsa trying to get their player of the year, Collier, off. Good defense inside against him, but Rollo, the center, one of his strengths is going to the glass. Had 17 rebounds in a game earlier this year. He's a guy that has to be blocked out, or he'll give Tulsa a lot of second opportunities.
A great day for the state of Oklahoma's basketball status today as Collier hits 6 of the 10 starters on the floor in this game are from the state, a state that doesn't always get a lot of respect for its basketball.
Early on, you get to see one part of Collier's offensive game, posting up. He's also a terrific three-point shooter. He can put the ball on the floor and take you off the dribble. He's an all-around offensive threat. Away from the ball, we'll watch Bryant Reeves. Big country inside. How much does he want the ball today? Is he going to move to get himself open, or will he allow himself to be taken out of the game as he was against New Mexico State?
Stillwater and Tulsa separated by about 60 miles. Stillwater a bit closer here to Oklahoma City, but still an easy drive for the fans of both schools. The crowd, I think, seems a little more partisan towards Oklahoma State, which obviously a state school, as Seals knocks down a 3.
That's the other guy we're going to talk about. In fact, when you look at Tulsa, they've got 4 terrific offensive players. Shea Seals, a freshman. Lou Dawkins, a senior, also the conference's best defensive player. Collier. And their point guard, Williamson. Two possessions, Reeves yet to touch the ball inside.
Lou Dawkins, Tulsa's best defender, playing Rutherford, although seeing how everybody drops down on Reeves, and he is out of bounds. So Oklahoma State has turned it over twice.
Well, when you're 7 feet tall, you're going to draw a lot of company. Reeves catches this ball inside, and look at Tulsa. Not hard to figure out that they feel they must stop him. At that point, Reeves has to get the ball back out, find somebody on the perimeter.
The first 10 against UCLA. They have scored the first 8 today.
I am so impressed with the way Tulsa comes out of the box. Usually when you have teams unaccustomed to being in this tournament, they have to stick their feet in the water, check the temperature before diving in. Tulsa, they're ready to go from the jump.
They're giving Keyani Roberts any shot he wants outside now. A foul called on the lean inside. It's against Tulsa, leaning on Reeves. J.R. Rollo picks it up. What a way to start. And you could tell what that start did to UCLA Friday. It stunned them. They weren't prepared for it. Oklahoma State, I think, will know. These teams played each other in December. Oklahoma State won the game by 12, although it was really an ugly game. Neither team shot well as Reeves hits. Eddie Sutton said in that neither team really played well in that game.
Reeves finally gets loose underneath. The double team not able to form quickly enough. Reeves had plenty of time to set himself for the turnaround jumper, but that has to be a constant. They cannot have that as infrequently as they did 2 days ago.
Collier got trapped in the baseline, and Oklahoma State's defense forces a turnover. And Keyonte Roberts finishes.
Good job defensively by Oklahoma State, and in transition showing that they're not the only team out there, or that is, Tulsa's not the only team on the floor that can run it up when the opportunity is there. Good floor spacing that time, excellent pass.
Rollo goes right at Reeves and hits. One of the things that we noticed Friday, Greg, about Tulsa was they spread their offense, and they've done the same today. Now, 4 of their 5 starters have already scored.
Well, that's why Rollo can get some touches inside. When you got the perimeter spread, Rollo's going to be open inside. Now, here's the steal by Thompson, and right into transition goes Oklahoma State. Look at that spacing, so that when Roberts gets it, he has a clear path to the basket for the layup. You hear that word a lot in basketball now, spacing. You got to have it. You got to give players with athleticism room to be able to maneuver.
Another hot shooting start for Tulsa. Good move left by Roberts. Keyonte Roberts, not a lot of offense, averages only 4.5 a game. He's going to force Collier to have to play him.
But that's one way to try and negate a terrific score. Make him have to work on the defensive end so as not to think all offense.
Seals goes into big country. Oklahoma State back with it. And a reach-in foul. So Oklahoma State doing a little running now, and they're doing it effectively. 2 fouls on J.R. Rollo.
Keyonte Roberts, a player averaging under 5 points a game, very active offensively. He's here so far, really helping his team get back into things early. Already has 4 points, has a chance to get 6 with the free throws. Shows good ball handling skills, especially in one-on-one situations.
So 2 quick fouls on J.R. Rollo, and that gets Tulsa's starting center a seat. The 2 high school players of the year in the state of Oklahoma on the floor right now, Shea Seals. But Tulsa was the big school player of the year in the state last year, and Keyonte Roberts, who grew up just north of Oklahoma City, and Edmond was the small school player.
Sub into the game now, the big guy, Rafael Maldonado. You know, he and Rollo collectively form one pretty good center for Tulsa with 12 fouls. Make that 10 fouls.
Reeves did a good job, but Maldonado's there for the follow. Reeves cut Collier off. Maldonado, who had maybe his best game as a Golden Hurricane against UCLA Friday. Starts quickly. Rutherford's first shot.
Rutherford burned New Mexico State for 27 points. He had a lot of room to operate on the perimeter because New Mexico State came in looking to take Reeves out of the game. They put a lot of people on him and sometimes weren't able to get back out on the perimeter.
Score it from Brendan Manzer and a foul.
Each time Oklahoma State is able to come up with the steal, they go right away in transition. Again, floor spacing, and Manzer up off the dribble with a three-point opportunity.
Just the third start of Brendan Manzer's career, 2 years here at Oklahoma State. Very, very good shooter.
Tulsa, an all-out up-tempo team. Oklahoma with the opportunistic break, getting back into it.
What do you get when you cross a high-quality conventional motor oil with an advanced formula synthetic? A revolutionary new oil that protects better than regular oils, yet costs 40% less than other synthetics. DuraBlend from Valvoline. People who know, use Valvoline.
At Geo, we've thought a lot about safety. That's why Geo Prism comes with standard dual airbags and available anti-lock brakes. In addition, it's equipped with a rugged steel safety cage. You see, we not only want to make accidents easier to avoid, we also want to make them easier to walk away from.
Call 1-800-GET-TO-KNOW and get to know Geo Prism with over 100 standard safety features.
Imagine adhesives so strong they help hold together 100 tons of soaring transportation. Imagine a fabric so bright it lets you see an accident in time to prevent it. Imagine a single disc so powerful it can store everything imaginable and protect it for a lifetime. These products and thousands more that make our lives better exist because the people at 3M imagine.
Mr. Brawley?
Yes.
Do you ever think about your HP LaserJet printer?
Not anymore. Before I bought it, I did.
What do you mean?
Well, I researched printers, and LaserJet gave me everything I wanted.
But now you say you don't think about it.
No, I don't have to. It works.
Hmm. Oh, I see. It works for you, and you ignore it.
Mm.
Is that fair?
Yes.
Oh, okay. We've seen it all before, LaserJet neglect.
Hmm. Well, I have the same problem with plants.
HP LaserJet printers. You do your job, we'll do ours.
New from Pizza Hut, the ultimate pepperoni pizza. With zesty herbs and spices and thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. This is the ultimate pepperoni pizza. But remember, one bite and there's no going back.
He was not the monster that the world made him out to be.
It takes someone like that to believe the Holocaust never happened. 60 Minutes tonight.
Right now, no bigger player for Tulsa than redshirt freshman Rafael Maldonado.
Well, Maldonado's still learning the game, got a late start in basketball, but as you said, a big game against UCLA, that certainly had to buoy his confidence. He's got to be a player on the floor now that stays out of foul trouble, considering that Rollo, the starting center, already has two.
Maldonado's pass sails out as the Cowboys bring Terry Collins off the bench, replacing Keonte Roberts. And we'll be watching Tubby Smith in this half to see how he plays it with Rollo. Team's off to a great shooting start. Shooting, for the most part, in this region is pretty good.
Kind rims.
Seals to Williamson. Great hesitation move on Sutton. But the Cowboys have the board.
And the numbers.
And Reeves beat Maldonado back down the floor. And boy, that didn't happen very often for Big Country the other day.
It certainly didn't. He was a plotter up and down the floor, but that time he was out early on the break. A lot of this happened because of the long rebound. But again, the opportunity break, and Reeves, a big much bigger target today, making himself available. He looks more convincing in wanting the ball than he did the other day.
Big 8 player of the year as a sophomore. Had a better year this year, but Missouri, with the undefeated conference season, swept almost all the honors. Reeves might be the leading scorer in school history by the time, the second leading scorer, I should say, by the time this season ends. And he still has another year to play. Good rebound by Shea Seals. Kwanza Johnson is in for Tulsa. Scott Sutton in for Oklahoma State. And the Cowboys have weathered the start. Tulsa got the first 8, but Oklahoma State has stayed strong.
Well, it didn't take them a complete half to open their eyes, as was the case with UCLA. Let's give UCLA credit. They played much better in the second half, but a 25-point deficit is a huge mountain to climb.
And Oklahoma State, Greg, was banking much of their hopes today on the fact that we mentioned at the outset, their defense is so strong. For all 4 years, Eddie Sutton has been a Cowboy coach. They've held their opponents to between 41 and 42% shooting. They said Tulsa's just not going to get those kind of shots today.
And so far, they're not. They've got pressure on the perimeter, and they're covering up on the inside. And Reeves, how about Reeves? Reeves is certainly more animated, looks more enthusiastic out there on the floor. This is not the same player we saw the other day. He was very robotic the other day and got frustrated and was a non-entity.
But he's touching the ball. He has more touches in the first 6 minutes here than he probably did in the entire first half.
Friday. That's right. 5 shots in the game against New Mexico State, 0 shots in the second half.
Find out, I think, maybe how much faith Tubby Smith has in J.R. Rollo. I'm not sure, with 12 or 13 minutes to go in this half, and Tubby can let this entire half go by without bringing Rollo back.
That's right, because right now Reeves is getting the best of young Maldonado position-wise, and then also the time when he beat him up the floor.
With 5 points, and Oklahoma State has come back to tie the game.
10-2 run answered with a 10-2 run.
Drew Dawkins a miss, good jump by Kwanza Johnson.
Just superb defense, man to man right now by Oklahoma State. That has allowed them to get back into this game. Gary Collier hasn't had one good look from the perimeter yet. Each time he catches it, defender right there in his face.
Little miss by Dawkins and a good job by Kwanza Johnson.
That's a tough shot.
Going to get a foul, I believe, on Manzer. Yes, Manzer of Oklahoma State, bringing down the big guy Maldonado. So Manzer picks up his second personal.
See, this is a tough shot again, posting up Collier. You see the defense inside by Collins. Collier with the force, but there's Maldonado. No way, Manzer, who had good position on Maldonado, but giving up a foot, you're not going to get that rebound too often. Perhaps a good job by Manzer to get the foul. Would have been an easy putback for Maldonado.
Other second round games underway. We'll keep you updated constantly on scores. Collier, a quick up. And he nails the three. Well, Collier knows now that the defense up so quickly on him, he's got to let it fly.
Hey, and he stepped back a little bit. That was almost an NBA three by Collier. Thing is, you can stop him, but for how long? He's very explosive. If you're Oklahoma State, you don't want him to get hot.
Brooks Thompson hits the leaner. Tulsa has made just 2 of its last 8 shots after a scorching performance in the first half Friday. Kevin Grauer in the game for the first time has the ball for Tulsa. And Rutherford clears it.
No free paths to the basket for Tulsa. Each time a Tulsa player puts the ball on the floor to try to get dribble penetration, he is being forced to have to pull up and shoot the J. Good defense by OSU.
And a great entry there by Scott Sutton to Brian Reeves. Now Johnson contested and a foul.
Still a lot of traffic, a lot of bumping inside. Maldonado, Reeves, but Reeves working hard. He knows that he's a key in this game. Consider this, in games where he scored 20 or more, the Cowboys are 17-2. They're just a 500 team, 7-7 in games when he's under 20. So he's very key to their hopes.
And Tubby Smith, with 11 and a half minutes remaining in the first half, has brought J.R. Rollo back in the game, hoping that Rollo can play probably not the rest of the half, but maybe some of it, without picking up a third foul.
That's going to be a key thing to watch. And I wouldn't even be surprised to see Tulsa go into a zone to try to protect Rollo, because against Reeves, you got to bump him. How can you not? If you don't bump him, he's going to camp down low and kill you. And when you're bumping, there's always a tendency to pick up a foul.
Very small lineup out there for Tulsa now, with Collier sitting. Rollo's the only player with any real bulk. Dawkins and Seals, both 6'5 on the floor. Tie game.
Whoa! Country knocks down Reeves and goes hard to the basket. Boy, he was running back and right guard all in one play. Took out his own interference.
Oh, Shea Seals up big.
That's one way to quickly quiet the Oklahoma State crowd.
Saying the Tulsa fans starting to make some noise. Lou Dawkins out of the pack. Seals trying to get it back inside. That's Oklahoma State's defense, though. They got back. And Keontae Roberts hits.
Keontae Roberts has been a big factor in this first half with his ball handling and his shot making.
Is possessed.
And he kept it in bounds. Big block shot gives Oklahoma State possession.
Well, the big fella is alive today.
Look at this. Boom! Just knocks Rollo out of the picture, calls for the ball, and goes hard to the basket. Big Country trying to win the battle for the state. And then look at this defensively. That's a spike. I'll take that in volleyball any day. Keeps it in bounds. That's what's so key in that particular play. And off in transition goes the Cowboys.
But you know, Greg, that's a spectacular play by Reeves. But the possession before that for Tulsa, to me, shows everything. Tulsa had a break. And Friday, every break they ran against UCLA, UCLA didn't get back. And they converted. And Oklahoma State got back. Tulsa had no shot.
Hey, Oklahoma State scouted that game, and they knew there was going to be a heavy premium on getting back and matching up, and they're doing a superb job of that right now.
1-1 for Keontae Roberts. And Rollo picks himself off the floor and has the rebound for Tulsa. Collier back in the game for the Golden Hurricane. Baseline, nice, pretty little touch. 7 quick points for Gary Collier.
Collier knows he's a marked man, but give him credit. He wants the ball. His motion is endless. He's taking a couple of tough shots, but he's got to get some scoring if Tulsa's to be effective.
Scott Pierce is in for the Cowboys as Reeves is sitting for a minute. Manzer. Forcing a foul. So Tulsa getting into some first half foul trouble. And that's Kwanza Johnson picking up his third foul. So a key man off the Tulsa bench has picked up 3 already. The team has 8.
Kwanzaa Johnson, a player who's playing a lot better. You certainly want him available.
Lou Dawkins back for Tulsa, and Thompson is going to get back for Oklahoma State. Now Tulsa stormed out of the gate again, scored the first eight, but Oklahoma State didn't wilt. And now we'll go to timeout with the Cowboys in front.
Let's look around the country right now. First, Clark, Marquette in Kentucky, halfway through the first half, and Marquette leads 17-10.
In the midst of a 10-1 run, Jim McElvain committed his second foul rather early, and they've gotten a nice contribution from McCaskill off the bench. Marquette, very strong when they can play from the front because of their good size and their ability to go inside, but Kentucky with the three-point weapon, never out of game.
Well, Roderick Rhodes was just blocked at the other end. Now the Warriors with the ball and a seven-point lead. Little three of their own. They double up the Wildcats right now. 20-10 Marquette. Boston College in North Carolina. Meanwhile, Billy Packer in Landover. 7 minutes into this game, BC has a one-point lead.
Very low-scoring game. Nobody really has gotten their offensive thrust going in this basketball game.
Winner of this game will play Indiana in the Sweet 16 down in Miami, Florida on Friday night. Check out the Tar Heels on this possession.
2-3 zone by Boston College on the inside. In North Carolina, a play they've run for many years, and with a guy like Stackhouse and his leaping ability, they come right in behind the zone, throw the lob over the top of the 2-3.
Well, we heard Clark talking about freshmen in this tournament. That was freshman to freshman. McInnes to Stackhouse, and we take you back now to Tulsa, Oklahoma State. Here's Ted Robinson with Greg Kelcher.
Back at the Myriad, Randy Rutherford, his first basket of the game, nails a three, and Oklahoma State now has its largest lead. They lead Tulsa by four. J.R. Rollo taking it right at Big Country Reeves.
That's a good move by Rollo. Again, you want to make Reeves play some defense. You can't be a passer all the time in the post. Here's that zone defense I anticipated Tulsa would try to protect Rollo inside. Of course, when you're in that zone, you have to extend it and get to the outside shooters.
And that's the, well, you really have two targets. Thompson and Rutherford can both nail the threes.
They certainly can, and they can nail them from deep, much farther back than the three-point line. So, again, the zone defense of Tulsa will be tested.
There's the three-point shooting. Oklahoma State is shooting 77%. And that'll stop the running game faster than anything.
Oh, my goodness. Country. Country. Couldn't get that one, but he's got two superb blocks so far, helping out defensively. The thing you want to do when you're 7 feet tall, you want to be an intimidator.
Bryant Reeves has a pulse today.
He's got a big-time pulse. He's alive, he's here, and he's active.
He now has 11.
And he's on cue.
Roberts, who's been an outstanding defender for the Cowboys lately, drawing the Collier assignment. There's another block, and that hits Seals in the back, and we'll come back to Oklahoma State. The big man is alive.
Big plaudits, of course, for Big Country as he completely shuts down the middle. But the thing for Tulsa, right in there, you've got to have J.R. Rollo making himself available. He cannot allow Country to go and provide help side. You've got to provide a drop-off for your teammates when they penetrate.
Reeves into it. 11 points and three blocks in the first 13 minutes. And Oklahoma State, boys, you see Marquette up to a shocking start against Kentucky, and the Cowboys are on the brink here of establishing a clear edge in this first half.
You know what they have right now? They have a good balance. Perimeter tough, inside tough with Reeves, and sometimes that's a very difficult combination to overcome. Tulsa's gonna have to figure this out some way. They'd love to be able to go back to man and give help inside, but again, when you talk about the foul situation and now Rollo back on the bench, the inexperienced Maldonado back in. Look for Reeves to continue to work hard inside.
Morallo sitting as Maldonado comes back. Gary Collier, who's having to work much harder for his shots today. Now Craig Hernady in for the first time for Tulsa. Well, Maldonado goes right back out.
We'll watch the defense that Tulsa falls back into. Maybe coming with some pressure right now, getting a quicker lineup on the floor. But again, I think they want to go man-to-man. You may see Hernady guarding Reeves, but getting quick help the minute he touches the basketball.
Tubby Smith was not pleased with what Maldonado did his first venture in the game. Reeves called for traveling. And looks around and says, wait a minute. Well, I've done that my whole life.
I think he was anxious that time. He came in, he looked at Hernady and says, no way you're going to be able to check me. And when he caught the ball, shuffled the feet.
Lou Dawkins. And there's the fourth Reeves block.
I'm just wondering for Tulsa, how many of those does he have to get before they finally realize they must look for the drop-off. Somebody's got to come available underneath when Reeves comes over to help.
Now the lead is 9, and Seals with a silencer.
That's the freshman of the year right there in the Missouri Valley Conference.
And what a huge recruit, a young man who stayed home. He turned down Seton Hall to stay and help his hometown school. He'd been going to Tulsa games since he was a little boy, and Nolan Richardson took the program to Providence. Right now, Reeves is just owning Tulsa inside at both ends.
Well, you certainly can't say enough about Reeves. He had to be salivating at an opportunity to show what he could do today after his subpar performance. He's a sound player in every area right now, both ends of the floor.
Hernady had to put that shot way up in the air. He was affected by Reeves. That'll stay with Oklahoma State.
This is Reeves on one end. This is his fourth block. And notice, Ted, he keeps them all inbounds, giving his teammates a chance to recover. And then trying to front him that time was Hernady. Excellent pass over the top. And Reeves doesn't waste any time. He takes it and flushes it.
Now, if you're Tubby Smith right now, here's where you see Reeves going to sit. And you say, my team's got to make up some ground right here. Look at some scores from the women's championship. Foul on the shot. Well, that's a bad foul called. Tubby Smith doesn't like it at all. That's a tough foul as Lou Dawkins whistled for the foul, and Rutherford will shoot three.
Lou Dawkins arguing with the foul, but knows it was not a good foul. Dawkins, the defensive player of the year, you know, Tulsa is so good this year, they just swept everything. Coach of the year, Tubby Smith, Lou Dawkins, defensive player of the year, Seals, freshman of the year, Collier, player of the year. Dawkins knows that he should have never fouled the jump shooter. You just get a hand up.
Dwayne Bonner in for the first time for Tulsa. Largest lead of the game. Tulsa started with the first 8, but it's been all Cowboys since. And now the lead is 11. Oklahoma State has made 14 of 18 shots so far. Rallo going against Pierce. And Pierce doing it with one hand. His right hand, a broken bone in it. It is wrapped up. Going to limit his offense. He went up with one hand to get that rebound.
Can't say enough about the defensive job done by Oklahoma State so far. Very few open shots, very few uncontested shots, be they inside or outside for Tulsa.
There's an offensive foul called on the Cowboys. At the conclusion of today's NCAA tournament game, we'll select the Chevrolet players of the game in conjunction with the award. Chevrolet donates $1,000 in the general scholarship fund both schools. And with a small percentage of the precincts reporting, Big Country has a runaway lead.
And he's rested, too. He's not a fatigue player out on the floor. He's been to the bench a couple of times, and that has to be very key in terms of defense. He's working hard on the defensive end. And you can do that when you're not tired out on the floor.
Rallo had great position and missed an easy shot.
Rallo missed it. Reeves altered it. It will not go down as a block shot, but it certainly will go down as a shot intimidated.
Good quick drive. Brooks Thompson right back. And Reeves puts it home.
Reeves has taken over this game. That's what he's done.
The victory for Eddie Sutton was that when Reeves just sat out that brief spurt, the Cowboys actually tacked a couple of points onto their lead.
See, here's the thing now. Reeves has been such a good defender inside. His teammates are not afraid to really get up and play aggressive defense on the perimeter because they have a confidence now, knowing that if their man gets by them, they've got someone to cover up for them.
And Dwayne Bonner, first good inside move by a Tulsa player. Let Reeves fly right over him.
Of course, Tulsa, they can get right back into this game because they're up-tempo and they're quick striking. Something that Oklahoma State must be concerned with. They cannot have a drop-off. That's the first open shot we've seen for a Tulsa player in a long time.
Well, that was, quite frankly, that was just a missed call because Dwayne Bonner took three steps. Everybody in the building saw it, and they didn't call it.
Well, that makes up for the knockdown by Big Country then, huh?
That's right. .27 left in the half. Bryant Reeves at Oklahoma State leading by 8. Put his personal stamp on this first half.
In a big way, both ends of the floor, 17 points, 4 blocks. And look at Oklahoma State's shooting percentage.
Tubby Smith would love to see his team at least keep it here, maybe knock a couple of points more off this lead in the last of 2 minutes and change. Huge opening half for Marquette.
Zone defense really clamping down to keep Bryant Reeves without the basketball. So the perimeter, again, wide open. Thompson, way too much time. He'll hit those 5 out of every 6 shots.
Reeves has 4 blocks and no fouls, so he's been able to really play free inside.
That's why I think when Rallo catches it inside, he's got to go at him a couple of times. He's got a couple of shots to go down. You got to be more offensively inclined and get some foul trouble on Reeves.
Manzer passed up an open 3 and sets up Reeves.
What did we talk about in the open? Reeves had to be more active inside. That is happening. We also said his teammates had to be more patient and allow him to work himself free. That has happened. The result, 19 first half points for Bryant Reeves.
Brendan Manzer getting his chance to start. Fred Burley's suspension played a fine half.
They have not missed Burley as of yet.
And Tulsa can't hold it for 1. That's what Tubby Smith wants. They get the lead in down to single digits.
Stunned a little bit because they came out on fire and they lost control. That'll help.
Boo Williamson, quiet half, but knocks a quick 3. Thompson, and he hits Johnson on the run to answer. And that, folks, tells you all you need to know about this first half. All Oklahoma State, they lead by 11. And now to New York and Jim Nance.
Half of play. It was an 18-3 Marquette run midway through the first half that propelled them to a 13-point lead. There's Tony Miller. Pieper saves it. They look for McCaskill. Miller back up. Tony Miller has been a spark plug for Marquette in this first half. Damon Key wants the ball. McElvain on the bench with two fouls. McCaskill, number 00, has played superbly. Can't get that one.
Somebody touched it while it was on the rim.
Jim Burr, the official, makes the call for basket interference. It may have been McCarty, and that may be what Rick Pitino is saying to Walter.
If that ball is on the rim, the defense can't touch the ball or the rim or the net. And right there's the net. That's a great shot, but that's what happened. The ball was on the rim. McCarty hit the net. That's a great call.
Bounce pass, Riddick, turns around, blocked by McCaskill. Amal McCaskill has come up huge in this first half.
It's not a good play by Riddick to take the ball at him like that. You gotta get the ball inside, get it outside to get some openings.
Anthony Pieper finds Lochterman, number 12.
Kentucky has gone back to the zone on the last couple of possessions. McCaskill wearing him out on the inside.
Lochterman for three. Riddick with good position comes down with the rebound. A 17-point Marquette lead. As Dan said, Marquette defensively leading the country in field goal defense. They yield only 30. Oh, good pass. Brasso gets the basket. They yield only 36% from the field. It's less than that in the first half here today.
They break the press easily once again, and that's been the key to the first half. Kentucky just has not been able to create turnovers and easy baskets off their pressure.
Pieper finds Lochterman again, and Damon Key. Takes the jumper baseline. Nope. Brasso for Kentucky. Shot clock is off. 25 seconds remaining. Kentucky is 1-for-10 from three-point range. And they're down by 15 points.
And the Marquette coaching staff looking for one more defensive stand to close out the first half.
Travis Ford with the ball. Brasso guarded by Pieper. Didn't want that shot. How about the Marquette defense?
The Marquette defense superb. That was terrible offense on that particular possession. What a first half.
I wanted to give you a chance to make that point.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA basketball championship.
Surprise, and Carolina in a fight with Boston College on the Pennzoil at the half.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
All right, welcome back to our studios in New York. We're at halftime for two ball games, and let's give you the scores in each of those two. First up, it's Oklahoma State by 11 as Brooks Thompson hit a shot right at the halftime buzzer just inside the midcourt stripe, and Oklahoma State leads out there in Oklahoma City. Meanwhile, Kentucky trailing Marquette as the top guns of the Wildcats really off right now in the shooting department. Marquette leads by 15. We want to send you out, though, to some action. Action including Carolina against Boston College. And right there you have it. BC leading by three. About 2 minutes, 20 seconds to go first half. Here's Greg Gumbel along with Bill Rafter.
7 points for the freshman Jeff McGinnis. 2:25 to play here in the first half. Boston College leading North Carolina by two. 36-34. They have gotten a monumental contribution from the freshman Donyay Abrams and some good outside shooting to stay 2 points up on the defending national champion.
Using the post guy for a reversal as well. He popped the lane. Screened by Donyay.
Abrams. Weaving his way inside, kicks it out to Isley for three.
Well, you see Abram jumping up. He's the beer man on the club. He's the killer. The other guys are the milkshake guys. He's got a little terror in him.
Eagles by five. A minute 40 to play first half.
Nice post up, the two big guys, and Billy Curley very fortunate.
Wallace on his back complaining. Meanwhile, the Eagles come the other way.
Rashid looking to help out on Curley. Donnier's going to have to make one of these or at least take one.
Abram in amongst the trees and comes back out. Isley, Abram puts it on the floor, rejected by Wallace. Isley, Abram for three. We're under a minute to play first half. Williams off the side. His three doesn't fall. Picked off by Abram.
What a check out by Huckabee. Giving up a ton of inches and able to ward off.
Huckabee.
Didn't need it. Nice save.
Tapped out. The save.
Look at the
made.
Presence of mind, huh? Everything flowing. Well, OB, a lot of people wanted him history a few years ago. He's got them shaking right now.
Is this halftime score going to raise a few eyebrows around the country?
They want to make sure it's the last shot. Don't give the Heels another opportunity. And Curley does not want a foul on a tip.
Isley, and now Abram around and out. And that'll do it for the first half. An outstanding first half for the Boston College Eagles. Steady play on the inside, sharp shooting from the outside.
What a story right there unfolding in Landover, Maryland, as North Carolina goes to the locker room down eight against Boston College. And Billy, how surprised are you about this?
Well, very surprised, obviously, because Boston College, a team that couldn't really get it over the hump in the Big East. North Carolina, however, having to go to zone, not able as a power team to shut somebody down with a man-to-man.
What are we going to see here in the second half, you think?
Well, I think you'll see much the same from BC. They're going to throw it inside when they can, but they'll look for the three-point shot. And as long as they continue to keep the lead, the longer that goes, the more the pressure shifts to North Carolina.
All right, again, some of the other scores taking place right now. Let's take a look. It's Virginia against Arizona. Exactly 10 minutes to go first half in that one out in Sacramento. And Virginia leads the two seed in the West, 14-13. Again, Marquette up 15, and Oklahoma State with an 11-point lead. They're getting set for the second half. In fact, we're going to send back the Oklahoma City audience to the second half for Oklahoma State. Tulsa, Kentucky, and Marquette, you'll come back as we'll continue here on the road to the Final Four.
Down on him, and when he catches, no hesitation, he goes right to the basket. Also doing it on the defensive end, a block ignites Oklahoma State's controlled, opportunistic break, and that's Manzer on the finish.
Now this flurry is a huge flurry at the end of the half.
Sure was. That was going to be a bright, bright light for Tulsa as the lead was back down under double digits, but Thompson has an answer, drops it down, and that was very symbolic of the first half for Oklahoma State. Many things going right.
J.R. Rallo did get through the half with just two fouls. They go right to Reeves, but Collier cannot corral the rebound. Great shooting from long range by both teams in the half. Overall, Oklahoma State sizzling at 64%. Back Tulsa, not bad. Oklahoma State's opponents only 41% this year, so Tulsa did 6 percentage points better than that in the half. Help!
Obviously, an 11-point lead is not insurmountable. But I think for Tulsa, they've got to be able to get the help inside on Reeves. They've got to keep him with as few touches as possible. But at the same time, they have to guard Thompson, who is 3 for 3 from three-point territory, and Rutherford, another outside shooting threat.
Tubby Smith had two or three major concerns in this game. One was rebounding. Oklahoma State's beginning to get a little edge there. Now Dawkins clears it. Tulsa looks to run.
Ooh, flat. Very flat. In fact, an air ball by Seals.
And they burn him at the other end.
behind as Keontae Roberts puts home the lob.
Key thing to note, 22 turnovers Friday against New Mexico State. But today, running a much more controlled break, taking it when it's there. Oklahoma State just 4 turnovers thus far in this game, doing a super job.
Good rebound by Brooks Thompson. Collier goes right in. Finally, Tulsa gets a foul on Reeves.
Again, spacing, that key word in basketball. In transition, you have to have it. And that time, OSU did. Perfect pass over the top from Thompson. And that's Roberts able to catch and drop it in. Oklahoma State looking good in so many areas.
All set up by Seals, bad misfire on a three.
He shoots a flat shot anyway, but that one, with a little defensive pressure at the very end, ended up catching the bottom of the net.
Well, this is when you look to seniors. Brooks Thompson playing well for Oklahoma State, and Tulsa's Collier, I think, going to try to take more of the load onto his shoulders here.
Yeah, he's going to have to, but he's not going to be able to do it by himself. I think they're going to probably start needing some penetration from Williamson. Williamson can get inside, perhaps draw the defense. That'll get guys like Seals, along with Collier, a little better, a little longer look on the perimeter.
Rutherford a miss. Tulsa trying to put a little run together. Lou Dawkins has had a quiet offensive day. Just 3 points. They spot Collier. Another shot that was harassed somehow.
This is a 5-on-2 break by Oklahoma State.
And here's Dawkins going in. Rutherford there. Oh, and Dawkins actually benefited by mishandling the ball.
Excellent observation, Ted. That's exactly what happened. That shot was going to be contested, but when he mishandled, the defender lost his timing. And Dawkins had an easy layup.
Boy, Reeves now has made 9 of 13 shots. There's a score that has everybody here buzzing. I'm sure all the sites around the country, as does that score. BC up 8 at the half. The winners here today are going to Dallas, and they will join Michigan and Maryland. Maryland, so far, of the first 8 that have advanced to the Sweet 16. Maryland, the only real surprise, as a 10 seed.
A young team that's playing extremely well, the Maryland Terrapins. And Michigan, how about Michigan and Steve Fisher? Steve Fisher now 19-3 in NCAA tournament games, 12-0 in games decided by 5 points or less.
Maldonado, the big guy in for Tulsa. Won't that Michigan-Maryland game be something at Reunion Arena? What a reversal of roles for the Fab Four now. All the pressure will be on them. They're expected to win, and Maryland will just go out there and have fun. Dawkins puts it in.
Tulsa now back to within 10. Some full court pressure, trying to get the tempo of this game changed. So far, they have been unable to force Oklahoma State to play fast and out of control. One player really, really stepping up in this tournament, showing just how good and valuable he is. Jawan Howard of Michigan. 34 points against Texas. 28 in the first game against Pepperdine. Think his stock isn't going up?
Well, I think both you and I have seen a lot of Big Ten basketball over the last few years, and you would say that Jawan Howard has clearly been the overlooked member of that team.
He must have gotten tired of that.
Headlines went other places, and that guy has done nothing but play outstanding ball. Rutherford. Williamson, great catch by Dawkins. And back is Terry Collins for OSU. That's not one of Reeves' better moves.
Ooh, a weakness exposed. Where's the left hand? Where's the left hand on that?
Oklahoma State by 10.
Something to work on.
Round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Mazda, Budweiser, and by American Airlines.
Arkansas watching. They'll play next against Georgetown, number one seeds. Greg, what did players do to get ready for a game before the days of Walkmans? There's Scotty Thurman sitting up there in the second row, and he's just had his headphones on, and he's...
We read.
What a novel concept. See, Collier trying to do it all with dribbles. Didn't have to do that against UCLA.
Didn't. Catch and shoot. Each time he caught it against UCLA, he had plenty of time to set his feet, take a comfortable shot. Hasn't had that today.
Both teams have dropped off a little bit early second half. Terry Collins the foul. He now has two. Collier 34 against UCLA. That was one short of his career high. Spent last summer working on his three. He was a 6'4 inside player. And last summer said, all right, now I'm going to get a perimeter weapon. Shot 46% this year from the three-point line.
Helped him become the player of the conference. Also helped Tulsa become a very tough basketball team. Players can make so much improvement in the summertime. It's amazing to see players when they leave school in June, come back in September.
Lou Dawkins, Tulsa can cut it here to 6. To 5, yes, as Collier hits.
Yes, catch and shoot on that particular play. Now, Oklahoma State going back a little bit too far defensively. You're usually taught get back to the paint and then match up, but with that three-point strike, you can't do it anymore. You got to match up much sooner.
Reeves spots Sutton. And Collins hits. Well, Scott Sutton has a remarkable ratio. Almost 6 assists to every turnover. We've seen him make a couple of nice entry passes today.
Yeah, he turned down a pass that time. Turned down a shot, that is, to pass it inside.
Williamson, and a reach-in fouls across midcourt on Rutherford.
Now, Brooks Thompson, who has been making pretty good decisions in this game, he's been criticized for his decision-making all week. It's the first time he got inside, got himself in the air, and had nothing to do with the basketball and ended up turning it over.
And that's why he's sitting where he's sitting right now.
And getting an earful. Big possession for Tulsa. They're looking at a chance to cut it to 5, possibly 4.
Lou Williamson now has 8.
He's getting the penetration that we talked about a few moments ago, and it's got to be consistent. He can cause problems when he's able to beat that initial surge of defense and getting to the blue area.
Kinds of trouble with Reeves, and Maldonado called for foul.
This is what penetration can get you. It makes you a double threat, and when you've got the quickness and ball handling dependability of Williamson, you can go inside. If you don't draw defenders, you can shoot it. On the other end, Maldonado trying to fight for the low box position, getting a little too physical there, and the foul is called on Maldonado against Reeves.
Greg mentioned in the first half, Maldonado has not played a lot of basketball in his life, and he is really having some troubles with Reeves today. Rallo back in. At least Rallo has been able to force Reeves into some tougher positions. Rallo has just picked up his third foul.
Now, if Rallo gets further foul trouble, and they have to go a long time with the inexperienced Maldonado, Tulsa could have problems. After Maldonado, there's Craig Hernady, and we saw what happened when he came in the first half. He just did not have the size nor strength to battle with Reeves.
you feel as Thompson checks back for Oklahoma State, would you feel, Greg, that for Tulsa to have a chance to win this game, Rallo has to stay in?
Rallo needs to stay in for defensive purposes, but also they've got to have consistent penetration from Williamson. That will open it up on the outside, I think, for guys like Collier and Seals.
Reeves 3 for 5 at the line today.
Ooh, too short, very short. Free throws, maybe a sign of fatigue on the part of Reeves. You don't usually see him that short.
Well, as this game tightens up, so does the Marquette-Kentucky game.
Here's one guy that really responds after getting chewed out. Remember yesterday? Eddie Sutton rode him all the way to the halftime locker room, Brooks Thompson, and then he came out and had a real nice second half. Now he gets chewed out, comes back into the game, and gets a key defensive play.
Williamson. Who Williamson pulls Tulsa within two.
Well, with Williamson, it's not all penetration. You got to play him in three-point territory, too, because he shoots 46% out there. Thing is, he just doesn't look to shoot as much. He likes to pass it. But he is a valuable shooting weapon.
And Manzer answers.
So is Manzer. Getting more time late in the season, a starter today, and showing that he deserves that consideration.
He has scored 11, and he has been the man who's had to try and stop Williamson most of the game.
Look at the hustle.
And he's done a great job on things like that.
That's the type of stuff that just doesn't show up on stat sheets, but it's the difference between winning and losing.
Great pass. Those are two great passes, one by Manzer and one by Roberts.
And it all started with the defense of Manzer, Brendan Manzer. He's having an effect on this game.
In his way, every bit as big as Bryant Reeves.
Well, his plays recently have shut down what looked to be a Tulsa run, some Tulsa momentum. His three-pointer, then his steal, and then his pass.
But Tulsa's getting hot.
They certainly are.
Collier up to 19. Tulsa's made 9 of 14 threes. Boy, is this NCAA tournament highlighted the three or what? I mean, people don't shoot foul shots anymore, but boy, they can knock threes down.
You know the home run is more exciting than a single?
Thompson sees the shot clock. Sets up Sutton. And Thompson has to fire. And boy, Kwanzaa Johnson knocked that rebound away from Roberts. Williamson beat Manzer left.
Penetration, quickness, ball handling ability, and dependability. He just doesn't turn it over, doesn't make a lot of mistakes, and Williamson starting to see that he can be an offensive threat, looking for his own offense.
He feels like he can beat Manzer. Reeves volleyballing, and a foul. That is going on Reeves.
He got away with the first tip over the back, but when the ball didn't go down, he continued to tip, and the official was right there on the call.
Is the play you'll see 14 and white make here for Oklahoma State.
Well, getting the hustle, giving up the body, and giving up the face. Look at this.
A face full of leather. On the other hand, Manzer and Williamson, I think it's been established that's a tough matchup, and Collier gets Tulsa even. And Gary Collier up to 21. He has taken over the scoring load for the Golden Hurricane.
Now Oklahoma State must recollect themselves. One player that has been unavailable most of the afternoon has been number 15, Randy Rutherford, right there. 27 points against New Mexico State. He has to become a factor in this game somehow.
Only one basket today by Rutherford. Thompson, a block by Pooh Williamson. Dawkins. And Tulsa leads. What a play by Pooh Williamson.
Where has this guy come from? Opportunity. Boy, when you get it, you want to take advantage of it. And Tulsa and Williamson in a big way. This is their opportunity, their showcase. And they're showing big.
Reeves. That had been the first lead for Tulsa since it was 15-14.
Brian Reeves continue to be consistent on the offensive end with his movement. And when he catches the ball right now, he's only 3 feet from the basket. So it's really a simple turn and shoot. Tough shot. Tough shot. That's the type of shot that can just kill your momentum. We'll see what happens here for Tulsa.
Approaching 9 minutes remaining in a tie game. And Rallo just picked up his fourth foul, and that's a flurry that may prove very key in this game.
Two things to consider here. If you're going to play topside defense on the post, look at Rallo on the top side. You better have superior jumping ability, making it very tough for the opposing team to lob over the top, or you better make sure you got backside help. Otherwise, it's going to be another simple catch and layup for Reeves. I don't think that Rallo has that big-time leaping ability. Better check the backside or either stay play behind.
Brian Reeves having a huge day. His 28th point. Shea Seals back for Tulsa. Second half Friday, UCLA making a run, and Tulsa had a 6-point play that stopped UCLA's momentum. Here, Collier takes a poor shot at one end. Williamson here. And the fourth foul on Rallo at the other end. That might be the kind of flurry that swings things right back to OSU.
Tulsa getting control of the game. 8-point halftime advantage for them so far. Reeves continuing to be a big factor in the 3-point shooting. A huge key for both teams.
Oh, well, we can both empathize with this.
Ooh, that thing goes back in with no lubrication. Don't like that.
Somebody else's finger, that's a hard one too. This is not for the squeamish, folks. Well, it's if you have a contact lens wearer in your team, I guess a most important part of any trainer's kit should be a little mirror. The way yeah. Ralph Hill could do it himself.
Put it himself, right.
This is interesting. I don't think, Greg, I'm not aware of any specific rule in the book that covers a contact lens situation. You still occasionally see, I saw it once or twice this year, games held up for the search on the floor when a lens pops out.
I think this probably goes down as an injury. Same thing, you see the officials blowing the whistle right away now when there are injuries, regardless to who has the ball. They're going to, I think, well, Maldonado is sitting down now, but no sub coming into the game, and they're probably going to have to wait on him because Rallo has the four fouls. Maldonado needs to be out on the floor for Tulsa.
8 minutes and 50 seconds remaining. Don Rutledge, lead official, now running down to tell Eddie Sutton, hey, look, how much I can do. Now they've got Raphael set. 3-point lead for the Cowboys. Team fouls are 6 against OSU, 3 against Tulsa. Able to see that ball. Dawkins tried the dish.
Had the right idea. Oklahoma State a better idea because they sank down into the paint area with four players, and any one of three could have picked that ball off.
Rutherford has not found the range today after a spectacular game against New Mexico State. He is 1-for-6 today. Shea Seals.
Fields again with that flat shot. That one got the bottom of the rim. He was defended very well on that play by Rutherford.
Oklahoma State led by 13 at one point in the first half.
Excuse me, Ted. Zone defense trying to help Maldonado out inside on Big Country.
Shot clock running down. Rutherford has to go up. And that's going right back to Tulsa. So we wind down towards 7 minutes. A three-point Cal City. This has been the toughest ticket in these parts for quite some time. The Midwest region, and even more so because two home state teams battling. Tulsa and Oklahoma State, a rivalry that had been discontinued, but Eddie Sutton resumed it when he took the job at OSU. And now they're meeting here in the second round of the Midwest region. Tulsa's won only two NCAA games in the history of their school. Oklahoma State's been to the Sweet 16 two of the last 3 years.
And one of those was a consolation game back in the 50s, so that didn't really count.
Seals hits a three, and that ties the game.
We had enough arc on that flat shot. Seals, he shoots it so flat. If it doesn't go straight in, he's not going to get any type of roll.
Maldonado still trying to lean on Reeves. Tulsa's starting center, J.R. Rollo, is sitting with four fouls.
See, Collins is the man with the shot now, and he's got to be able to shoot that ball because Collier, guarding him for Tulsa, really dropping back into the paint area to help out on Reeves. Last time he turned that shot down, did Collins. Or Roberts, that is, I'm sorry. This time, buried it.
Williamson with the answer. 15 for Pooh Williamson. It was played another turnover-free game. He has not had a turnover in 75 minutes in this region.
Coach's best friend, a point guard that doesn't turn the ball over.
Collins free. Collins with a layup. So 6 points here in the second half by another non-scorer, Terry Collins.
Collins with patience on that play, let the airways clear, the defender go by and laid it up off the high glass.
Collier, oh, we're getting big time shots going down at both ends. Collier has 23. That's a point more than his season average. Reeves has 28 for the Cowboys. And now Eddie Sutton on the Oklahoma State bench calls a timeout.
Jim, Billy, and Clark back in New York. The action hot everywhere. In fact, in Landover, Maryland, North Carolina has raced back from 14 down in the half to tie Boston College. And Carolina's point guard, Derek Phelps, on the bench with a mild concussion right now. Billy, it's been a long time since Carolina failed to make it to the Sweet 16.
Back to 1980, and of course, what's going up against Boston College right now is the depth factor. Abram particularly has had to play an awful lot of minutes against the substitution pattern in North Carolina. It's starting to tell a little bit.
All right, a timeout called there by Boston College as they were trapped. So that game 53 all. Meanwhile, Marquette and Kentucky. Marquette has led by as many as 18 in this half. And now here come the Wildcats, a three to tie it with 7 minutes remaining. Ooh, they had a shot at it. How has Kentucky gotten back into this game, Clark?
It's one simple shot, the three-point shot. They've made 7 of 11 from behind the arc in the second half alone. Delt has 18 of his 20 in this half. And when you're trading threes for twos, you compare leads in a hurry.
Kentucky, a team that came back from 31 down this season against LSU to win. Meanwhile, in Sacramento, Virginia against Arizona. And Virginia's crawled back within six here, Billy. They've been able to withstand a 21-2 run by Arizona. It looked like it might blow the game open.
We're on our third different game here. Virginia had it going their way in regard to the patient, low-scoring beginning of the first half, and then terrific comeback with outside shooting, particularly Stoudemire got him started for Arizona, an entirely different makeup of the game. And here we have in the second half the third game taking place with Virginia now back in their tempo.
All right, let's send it back. Randy Rutherford's just knocked down a three for the Cowboys to give him a one-point lead. Back to you, Ted Robinson.
A crowd roaring here at the Myriad as Seals puts it back in to give Tulsa the lead. Randy Rutherford had just nailed a three for Oklahoma State, but a big putback by Shea Seals.
The same thing that helped Tulsa against UCLA is starting to happen now. They're starting to get all of the loose balls, all the scramble rebounds, and all of the breaks, but they're creating those breaks themselves with just tremendous hustle. Look at this. Loose ball on the floor. Looks like Reeves is going to come up with it, but no. Seals, and he was very strong on the putback.
Now, during a dead ball, Tubby Smith and Tulsa takes their first timeout. Minutes or so, Reeves has not had many touches, and he just spent some time, I think, planting some seeds with Don Rutledge about what's going on down low.
Hoping to get a call later on, but you know he's played a lot of minutes. He's a big guy. He's a Winnebago, and you know they don't get very good miles per gallon. So he may be running out of steam just a little bit here.
Manzer and Sutton both in a long three. And Tulsa with the ball with the lead. Tight games all around the country in second round action this afternoon. Collier going left again, another tough shot.
See, right now, you have to really value each possession, and you got to make sure you get a great shot. Now, that's a shot Collier can hit, but it's not a good shot at this stage of the game. If I'm Tulsa, I'm getting the ball in the hands of Williamson, and I'm going to let him create and go off his decision.
Great entry, and Reeves puts the Cowboys in front. 30 points for Bryant Reeves.
Time for the big guys to step up. Reeves coming up for OSU that time.
And Williamson off the double screen that Tulsa used so well against UCLA. And Pooh Williamson has tied his career high with 20 points.
And still no turnovers.
Rutherford.
What a beautiful game. Each team answering after the other team seemingly delivers a knockout punch. This was going the full 15, folks.
Dawkins going in. Wipe it out. A foul first. Foul on the way. No basket. And this will be the seventh foul on OSU. The Myriad in Oklahoma City, just a marvelous game winding down to the last minute and 1 second. We've had great play by both sides in the last 3 or 4 minutes. Big shots at both ends. And Lou Dawkins of Tulsa will be going to the line here to shoot a 1-1. And he can put the Golden Hurricane, the 12th seed, back in front of Oklahoma State, the 4th seed.
I think we should underscore that word, marvelous, because that's exactly what this game has been. Both teams coming up big down the stretch. And it's unfortunate because the loser will go away feeling like it was one they should have had. And the loser will be absolutely correct.
What a rebound. Gary Collier, Tulsa's best player, 25 points. Now Tulsa has only 3 team fouls. They can foul if it's not in a shooting situation.
Good place to go.
Seals rebounds.
OSU can afford to play defense without the foul. They need the ball back, but they're going to get it back. There's time on the clock. Play solid defense here. Get a defensive rebound.
And Eddie Sutton waving no foul to his team. They want it straight up. Dawkins. Lou Dawkins hits a three. The biggest shot of that senior's life. And Tulsa leads by four.
NCAA championship can be pretty stressful, which is why we at Oldsmobile recommend that if you're going to watch for the next 3 weeks, you consider getting an 88 LSS. With all kinds of relaxing comforts to help you take your mind off the stress of the world outside. You see, if you had an LSS right now, you wouldn't be nearly so tense. It's your money.
See this? It won't make you smarter. When it was decided how smart you'd be, your credit limit didn't matter. You can't buy intelligence, okay? Well, maybe you could. I mean, no card is more accepted on the planet than MasterCard. So you could buy books and computers and chemistry sets, and that could make you smarter. And Master Value's discounts can save you up to 25% at thousands of stores. And if that's not buying intelligence, at least it's buying intelligently. So maybe a MasterCard could make you smarter. We ought to get you on a quiz show. MasterCard. It's more than a credit card. It's smart money.
From Gillette comes a revolutionary form of antiperspirant protection. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. Because it's a clear, clean, powerful gel, it goes on smoothly with no white residue to form an invisible barrier of protection. All-day protection against both wetness and odor. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. One of the advanced deodorants and antiperspirants in the Gillette series.
Was not the monster that the world made him out to be.
It takes someone like that to believe the Holocaust never happened. 60 Minutes tonight.
With Greg Kelser, Ted Robinson in Oklahoma City, Lou Dawkins just hitting the biggest shot of his college career.
See, here's the thing that really makes Tulsa tough. At the end of a game, it's really hard to key on any one guy because they got four players out on the floor that can kill you. Dawkins, Williamson, Collier, Shea Seals. Collier on the penetration, drew the double team, smartly kicked it off to Dawkins, and Dawkins hit perhaps the biggest shot of his life.
For 3 years at Tulsa, Lou Dawkins was not a factor at all offensively, and Tubby Smith told us yesterday that's been the biggest change in Tulsa this year. Lou Dawkins became someone that could score. Tulsa has just taken a timeout after Oklahoma State took one following the Dawkins basket. You see again, close games everywhere, but this one coming down to the final 8 seconds here. The 12th seed within one step of the Sweet 16. Brian Reeves owned this game in the first half, Greg, but I think Pooh Williamson, more than anyone, has owned it in the second half.
Yeah, see, this is really what happens when you have teams coming out of some of the more obscure conferences. Tulsa, not a lot of TV coverage, a virtual unknown, but this is not a 12th seed team.
They said their win Friday did so much for their image and their recruiting. Tubby Smith, their coach, was inundated with faxes and phone messages and congratulations from Tulsa fans and supporters all around. And if he could win an in-state game like this, not just an NCAA game, but over one of his big rivals, what a boost for the Tulsa program. Coming up next here in Oklahoma City, the number one seed Arkansas playing Georgetown.
Look for Tulsa to try and keep pressure on the ball, but no foul. Force Oklahoma State to use some of that clock and clamp down on the rebound.
Will Tulsa foul here, Greg? They have only three team fouls.
They may give one. You know what? That's a good thought. They may give a foul, maybe even give two, to try to take some time off the clock and not allow Oklahoma State to get a good shot off.
They can foul right here in backcourt.
Seals knocks it away. Reeves with a tip and a time with 1.4. Tulsa lead is 2. Lou Dawkins made the 3 that has Tulsa in front. Now throws the long inbounds. And that is it. The Tulsa Golden Hurricane are to the Sweet 16. What a moment for Tubby Smith. Tulsa has won 2 NCAA games in 3 days. Their entire history before this week, they had 1 win in the tournament. Now they're going to Dallas as they beat Oklahoma State 82-80. Bryant Reeves leaving after a 32-point day, and Tulsa, a 12th seed, heads to Dallas. And coming up next here, it's Arkansas and Georgetown. Our Chevrolet players of the game, Alvin Pooh Williamson for Tulsa and Bryant Reeves for Oklahoma State. The celebration for Tulsa, now to New York in Jim Nance.